Delrick, and welcome to VIPFest! The video crew is here tonight, so please allow the video record our show. So we appreciate all of them being here, and we appreciate you being here, right? These kids have worked really hard. We have about 2 weeks and 2 days to put these shows up, and here we are performing them already. We're so excited. And here we have William Shakespeare, long lost first playwright, in the house! Amazing shows going on this weekend, so please remember that when we are on intermission, another show may not be at intermission. When we're finished, another show may not be finished yet. So please be respectful of all the other shows that are still going on while we perform our show. The other thing is the fire exits. The use of flash photography is strictly prohibited unless you'd like to take a picture now. Fine. And of course, Fosse. Watch out, front row, you might get a little Fosse on you, but that's okay. So I do want to thank a lot of people who have been here working on these shows, and especially our design team, which is assessed by Jacqueline, lights by Jess, excuse me, John did the costumes, Riley did the props, Dustin did the hair and makeup, Samuel did the sound, and then we have all of their crew, including the paint crew and construction crew. They work as a great team, so let's give them all a big Chloe and Dylan here working on our spot, so thanks for taking the time out to do this. Appreciate that. Our immediate team here is we have an assistant stage manager, Emily, who's backstage running things, Megan, who's up in the booth running things, and Eve, the assistant choreographer. So stage managers, assistant choreographers, thank you for all of your work.
Thank you. father had sent him.
So that he might embark upon his life with the maximum of choices and possibilities.
And then so distinguished himself at the university that the faculty bestowed upon him the special title of
Scholar of the House!
And he made me a little nervous. This is his first time playing the part.
Can I have some more lights, please?
Well, he's not that nervous.
Thank you. Gentle tutors, respected members of the faculty, I'm very grateful for the knowledge you have given me, but I'm afraid what I'm looking for can't be found in books.
And Pippin made a promise.
I promise not to waste my life on commonplace, ordinary pursuits. I am going to live a life that's extraordinary. I know there is something up. Can't quite find a word for it.
Fulfilling! Something completely fulfilling.
Yeah, that's it! Something completely fulfilling! And I'm going to find it. I don't exactly know what I want to do or where I want to go. Everything has its season. Everything has its time. Show me your reason and I'll soon show you mine. Cats fit on the windowsill. Children fit in the snow. Why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. Everyone has daydreams. Everyone has his goal. People like the way dreams have sticking to the soul. Thunderclouds have their lightning. Nightingales have their song. But don't you see, I want my life to be something more than long. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free.
Well, Pippin, good to see you.
Wait, Father, you know we have a library now. Maybe you can find a book.
Thank you.
After all, tomorrow is for you.
But it's still today.
Yes, but for how long? You'll see, Pippin. Sunrise and sunset are similar, but not identical.
Father, what does that even mean?
Enter Louis, Pippin's stepbrother, and after Pippin, heir to the throne. Addicted to the physical, Louis loves weightlifting.
You're going to war against the Visigoths.
That's an excellent. It's gonna be a glorious campaign. Oh, and those Visigoth women. I don't mean to shock your bookish sensibility.
I'm only shocked you're interested in women now.
Enter Bestrada. Pippin's stepmother. Crafty. Cunning. Calculating.
But a warm and wonderful mother.
Dedicated to gaining the throne for her darling son, Louis.
Louis! Guess what mommy had made for you?
Johnny, what we got for Louis today?
On the Etruscan manor, modeled after Romulus or Remus, this armor breastplate is all yours, Louis, because your mommy loves you!
Surprise!
Oh, think how I'll shine. Look at it. Isn't it beautiful?
It really is beautiful.
Of course it's wonderful. Louis is a great warrior.
You know, sometimes I wonder if the fornicating I'm getting is worth the fornicating I'm getting.
Father, I know what I want to do now.
What? Oh, good.
I want to be a soldier.
What? Deny!
Father, I'm your oldest son, and that means I'll be king one day. And fighting wars is an important part of being king, isn't it?
Fighting wars is the most important part of being king. And after all, the Pope and I have dedicated ourselves to spreading Christianity throughout the entire world, even if we have to kill every non-Christian to do it.
Exactly. So I want to join you in your campaign against the Visigoths.
Deny!
But that's not fair. You're taking Louis.
Yes, well, your brother Louis is an ideal warrior. He's strong and stupid. You, on the other hand, are well-educated.
And for what, Father? You're dedicated to something. I just want to be dedicated to something, too. With all my heart and soul. Otherwise, my life won't have any meaning at all.
Oh. Want your life that meaning?
Yes, I do.
Well, that's very ambitious of you.
Deny. But Father!
Deny,
Father! Stop all this bullshit!
Oh. All right, then. Grab yourself a decent number and come on!
I'm a soldier.
Yes, you are.
Me, a warrior, finally a chance to do something important. A chance to use my sword, my arm, maybe even my blood!
Glory! Glory!
Strategies and strategies, statistical analyses, Cena. Then the enemy in blue will undoubtedly pursue, but we hope you keep your lawsuit to comparatively few.
Praise be to God our Lord, to our
nothing yet, folks.
Simple joys and simple voices, time is living fine. Our best days are history.
fresh fruit off your culture. Oh yes, women.
Sex presented pastorally.
Why can't I find something completely fulfilling?
Look, you just got started.
What?
Like taking a look at this?
Peasants revolt. King slays thousands. Peasants protesting a rise in taxes slaughtered yesterday by Charlemagne's soldiers. What? This can't be true.
Now, the internet say anything that wasn't true.
But my father would never slaughter people just for protesting.
Why not? He's the king. Charlemagne today gives orders that non-believers be given a choice between baptism and beheading.
Wait a minute! Forcing people to believe, telling them what to think? Something's gotta be done about this!
You are absolutely right.
I'm finally beginning to see what my father really is. He forces people to fight and die over land that doesn't even belong to them!
He does!
Well, I think this has got to stop!
It has got to stop!
It's time for a change!
Damn it, it is time for a change!
We can't wait around waiting for others to take action. Otherwise, one day we'll look around and ask, what happened? What happened is that we failed to act!
Down the charge! Down the charge! Down the charge! Down the charge! Testing! Testing!
It's time to make a better world for all people! Not just the rich and powerful! This tyrant must be overthrown! Terror and bloodshed must be ended! We need a leader with the youth and courage to sweep out the old order! Down with Charles! Up with me!
Really helping myself. You may come in.
I'm sorry to disturb you, my son. I know you like to pray alone.
You know who I am, Father?
Of course, my son.
Want something from me, perhaps? A favor, Vincent.
I'm here to be with you for one moment, to look into your eyes.
What do you see?
I see two eyes, a little cloudy danger, sunset.
What else?
The deaths of thousands, the slavery of more, terror and bloodshed.
I see all that in my eyes.
Do you like it?
Light. I'm proud of it. I brought order out of the chaos. If terror and bloodshed were necessary to achieve that order, then so be it.
Those are words of the past. Time has swept you by, my son.
And your time has come, my son.
Yes, Father.
So easy from where you stand to judge the things I have done. Eagles, ospreys, even vultures had a better view. From the heights, everything was very clear. But when I marched, I had the dust of the road in my mouth. And when I fought, I had the blood of the enemy in my eyes. But by God, it blew my breath across the continent, shaped an empire with it.
Father, maybe you did the best you could, but things have to change.
And you're the one to change them.
Yes. I am. Well, truly that. So we have one thing we can do. Thank you. I brought my own.
Then use it. Go. Lead me to my prayers.
What do you pray for, Father?
Strength. God give you the same.
Stop shaking when all the earth is still, when ancient ghosts are waking, so many steps need to, so many plans need making. I think I will. I think I will.
Your Majesty, King Pippin! Your Majesty!
Morning glow starts to glimmer when you go against.
all be dealt with fairly. My invitation extends to high and low alike.
Sire, I am a poor man.
You may stand. You may all stand.
Sire, I'm a poor man, a peasant. I own not 1 millimeter of land which I've worked so hard all my life. Is that fair?
No, that's not fair. But I will do something about it. From now on, I decree that all peasants shall own the lands they cultivate.
King Pippin the Just!
But sire, now that you've given our land to the peasants, we loyal nobles have no source of income. Therefore, we can no longer pay taxes.
Well then, I abolish taxes!
King Pippin the Generous!
I don't need an army. No taxes. No army.
King Pippin, the peaceful. Sire, sire, sire. Sire, it is my duty to inform you that the Emperor Hans of Frank in the east.
Thank you.
king makes budget cuts, the arts are the first to go.
So he dedicated himself to the church, the religious life. He longed to be touched by an angel, but what he discovered was...
It wasn't an angel who touched me.
I
knew.
Guess his name.
Augustus.
Wrong, his name's Otto.
You know, I'm smart to know that a duck belongs in the pond and not in my bed.
Pippin! You've been lying in this bed for 7 days now. What is the matter with you?
It's nothing you could possibly understand.
Well, try me. Give me a chance.
Right! I've been searching and searching for something important and fulfilling to do with my life. And I've tried everything I can think of, and I haven't even come close. So I'm in complete, abject, utter despair.
And that's it?
Yeah! That's it!
Pippin, let me tell you a little something about despair. I loved my husband very much. The years we spent together were the happiest years of my life. And then, one day, he was struck by fever. When one hand went cold in mine, I felt that my life, too, was over. I was overcome by the deepest despair. I took to my bed for 5 days. And then, on the 6th day, I got up. There were things to be done, an estate to be run, a boy to raise. Pippin, this is such a large estate, and I can't do all this work by myself. Couldn't you please
hold it? Hold it! You're supposed to read the line, nagging.
But he touched my hand. They don't usually do
that. I don't care where he put his hand. Read it, naggingly. I got my eye on you.
Pippin, this is not the largest day. I'm all alone. I gotta get to all this work for myself. Can you please help me out?
All right, all right! Anything to shut you up.
Well, Pippin was blinding me.
Every day! That's exciting!
Well, for a while, Pippin didn't show much enthusiasm. And as time went on, he showed no enthusiasm at all.
Keep up the good work, men! What? What are you looking at?
Nothing. But will Pippin there be something? The roof on the chicken house is going to leak if you can get to that tomorrow. Oh, and the field needs plowing, the chicken needs bricks, and the big size of. Aside. Thank you.
I used to be emperor of the Holy Roman Empire! All right, I screwed it up, but still. Patching the roof and punching the hay is not the idea of a perfect day. You're extraordinary, you got an extraordinary thing. Oh, I'm the type. Thank you.
and then Theo's duck got sick.
Pippin! Pippin, we're all sick!
That's too bad, Theo. I'm sorry.
Pippin, it's the first time he's coming to you for help. Could you look at him, please?
Theo, I don't know anything about ducks.
Please.
Right, let me have a look at him.
Now, say something hopeful.
I'm sorry, Theo, this is a very sick duck. There's nothing I can do. Oh, wait a minute! Theo, come here. Come and kneel down here next to me.
It was like a painting. Man and boy and duck at prayer.
His breath has left. His pulse is low. His feet are webbed, though. Even so, you must know that although our tears are poised to burst, we've kept our faith warm through the worst. We haven't cursed our luck or run amok. To prayer we stuck. Please reward our luck and save this duck. Love.
that's it? That's the finale?
Oh no, Tiffin, that's just the big build-up. You're the finale.
Me?
Become part of the fire. Be engulfed in the fire. Become fire itself. In the flame, you'll become a glorious synthesis of life and death.
And life again.
Wait a minute. You want me to blow myself up?
Pippins, you're an extraordinary human being with extraordinary aspirations and dreams.
You deserve an extraordinary life. Like the sun blazing in the sky.
The sun, I can see it.
About her golden eyes.
How she likes the world.
light.
Never was there.
And no magic!
Ladies and gentlemen, we apologize for our inability to bring you the finale that we promised. It seems our extraordinary young man has elected to compromise his aspirations. But I know there are many of you out there. Extraordinary people, exceptional people who would gladly trade your ordinary lives for the opportunity to do one perfect act, our grand finale, and we'll always be here for you anytime you want. Why, we're right inside your hands. And we promise you sets, costumes, lights, magic!
Magic!
And a short but spectacular career. Alright, show's over. Everybody out, you heard me. Out! Take out the rest of the lights. Orchestra, pack up your instrument, let's go. You try singing without music, sweetheart.
I wanted magic shows and miracles, mirages to touch. I wanted such a little thing from life, I wanted so much. We never came close, my love, we nearly came near. It never was there, it always was here.
How do you feel?
Trapped center stage. But happy. Could you turn off the lights, please?
Rivers belong.